No, I'll tell you. So next, my talk is about understanding the settings of the mirrorless camera systems for anterior segment and posterior segment surgeries. Now, the photographs that you are seeing there are all shot on the Sony A7 S2 camera. So, can commercial mirrorless camera match the medical grade cameras? So, first disclaimer that I would like to put is, if your approach to recording surgical videos is like fill it, shut it, and forget it, then forget it. Don't think about buying any of these cameras. You need to put in your mind a little bit so that you can shoot good quality videos. So it's important to understand, great photos are not produced by costly cameras, but they are produced by good photographers who know how to use it. So this is very, very important even for when you are using these cameras. Otherwise, you will buy it and then you will say, sir, it's not recording well. It's not that. The camera is good, but we should understand the settings. So it's important that we should be passionate about what we are doing. Then only you will get the results. So let's not cook up, but let's try to cook a good meal. So to create great videos, you should understand what is the hardware that is required. Then creating great videos is not just about the hardware, but also about the camera settings. And it's also important to understanding the lighting during the settings. So this is very important. So there are limitations. There are limitations. We have to accept the limitations. And then we should work around those limitations, how we can overcome those limitations. So the first aspect of photography is to area of center, interest. That should be centered, that should be focused. Then you should have adequate lighting. Then understand the settings to get the great quality images under different light settings. So whatever light setting you have, then if you are going to use that light setting, then use the correct camera setting for that light setting. That's how it works. So first of all, before you start, first thing is clean all your microscope optics, set your eyepiece to zero, adjust your IPD. All these things need to be done. Then connect your camera to a TV or a monitor, and then adjust the focus. So what is important is your focus and the camera focus should be same. If it is not same, you will be viewing it correctly and focused, while your recording will be not good. So first thing is both of them should match. So how do you do that? So in this adapter that we have, you have a focus ring here. So this is the mirrorless camera. This is the adapter here, and this is connected to the beam splitter. So you have a focus ring here. So that ring, if you move it, it will focus the image. So that thing you should understand. So what I do actually is to use a barcode. So it's there on any of our consumables. So take a barcode. See, now this image is not focused. Then I'm turning the focus ring to focus it. So now both the focus for the surgeon as well as on the camera are same. See, this is how it is. So even if you go to the at such high magnification, all the lines are very clearly seen. Now once you have done this, then all your videos are going to be very well focused. So the adjusting the camera settings depends on the type of the surgery, as we already discussed. For anterior segment surgeons, you don't worry too much at all. You don't have to worry about what all I were talking about, because most of it is required for retinal surgery. If you're going to record cataract surgeries, you just put it at auto ISO 400 or 800, one time you set, and that's the end of it. You don't have to worry about anything else. Just I'll tell you the shutter speed at what you have to do. After you have set that, nothing else. If nobody is going to fiddle the camera, you are going to get great quality recordings. But however, every camera will have a different setting. Suppose I say on Sony camera 400 ISO, it is not the same ISO on a different camera. So you need to individualize it for your setup and your beam splitter. So your beam splitter, if you have a original beam splitter from Zeiss, then you will be able to shoot at a lesser ISO also, because the transmissibility of the light will be much better in a Zeiss compared to a locally made beam splitter. So all these optics will interfere with your recording and your settings. So what you need to do is you need to spend some time, achieve the optimal setting for your setup, and once you have done that, you know, okay, I just have to do this and that's the end of it. Okay. So the camera settings, you have to understand the light, as I told you, then you have the shutter speed, then you have the aperture, then you have the ISO. So most of the times, shutter speed for video recording, once you have set it at particular level, you don't have to fiddle with it. So that's a one-time setting that you need to do. Only thing that you need to change is the ISO. Again, if you are only doing a cataract surgery, you set the ISO one time and that's the end of it. There's no need to do anything. For those people who do anterior segment and posterior segment, so there you need to shift it to the changes. So in the camera, so shutter speed, we usually keep it at 25 frames per second. And when you keep the frame rate at 25, the shutter speed should be double that. That is 1 by 50. That is how it should be. This is very important. So then only you will get an image which is sharper and good. If you are going to pause a video, you will still be able to get a good quality image out of the video. So ISO setting is the sensitivity of the camera sensor to the light. So the more the light you have, lesser the ISO you should set. So in cataract surgery, 200 to 400 is more than sufficient. For a retinal surgery, you need to increase the ISO because you are doing in low light. So lesser the ISO, better the image. So you try to get the least ISO setting for your setup, then that will give you the best quality image. That is very important. So now let me show you my experience, how we all learned by experience. This was a rented camera in Bangalore. This is my first shot on that camera. We had set the ISO at 400. Now you can see that it is not very clear. Now I increased the ISO to 12,500 and the anterior segment completely washed out. So here you can see that now I'm reducing the ISO. Now you can beautifully see how the video got corrected. So what we have to do is, there's an auto ISO mode, there's a minimum and a maximum. All you have to do is, the minimum you leave it at 100 and maximum, depending on whether you're doing a cataract surgery or a posterior segment surgery, set it at 3000 or 1600, whatever it is. And once you've done that, then it adjusts to both the anterior segment and posterior segment. So anterior segment surgeries, this is the rates that you can use. The shutter priority mode you have in the camera, there's something called as a shutter priority mode for video recording. You can use that. ISO between 400 to 800 is more than sufficient. Frame rate, either you can keep it at 25 or 50. And once you keep the frame rate at 25, your shutter rate should be, shutter speed should be at 1 by 50 or 1 by 100. That is, if it is 50 frames, then it will become 1 by 100. So these are the things that you need to do. This is a one-time setting that you do, and after that, forget about it. So now I am going to show you, this video has been shot on the Sony A7S2. Okay, see the quality of the blood vessels that you are seeing. Now I am zooming it further, I am cropping the video. This is shot in high definition, not on 4K also. And those of you who can watch on the TV, just see the difference between the TV and the LED screen. So on the TV it will be much, much better. See, I have gone further down, further zoomed up, I have further zoomed up. All, and this is not anything else, just by cropping it on video software, video editing software. So you need to understand each and everything to get such good quality videos here. See, we have zoomed up so much, still we are able to get such good quality focused image. Now coming to the retinal surgery. So retinal surgery is a different ball game. Why? That is because the lights. So you have different gauges. You have a 23 gauge, you have a 25 gauge, you have a 27 gauge. Then Some surgeons hold the light near the port, some surgeons hold it the light very close to the retina. So the light which is coming is at different levels and at different intensities. That makes recording retinal surgeries very difficult. That's why you require more settings to play around. And you also have wide angle systems, you have different optical elements now coming in, you have a re-inverter. So in a cataract surgery, you don't have all of them. So in retinal surgeries, all this adds to the loss of light that happens during the surgery. So these are some videos that I'm going to show of what is happening during the surgery. Now this looks okay. Now I'm trying to peel that small membrane there. Now my light pipe, because I'm concentrating on the peeling, my light pipe has gone closer. Now the video is getting blown out. That is because the tissue that there is highly reflective. Now once I remove that membrane, then the things look okay. So in retina, when you are doing retinal surgeries, the if you have a wide proliferative tissue, then you have to reduce your ISO settings so that it is not becomes highly reflective. So for some more videos I'm going to show in the retinal surgery. Here there is a patient who's got a detachment. Now you see that different layers having, because it is detached, the reflection is different at different levels. So this is the quality of the video that we are able to shoot if you have the correct recording settings. Rajesh? Yeah. Now I also want to show you the difference between, not only that, it's very important to understand that when you are recorded this surgery, it depends on what you are viewing. Okay, if you are viewing this system on a LED screen which is not in full HD, then actually it doesn't serve the purpose. Now for those who are there, we'll be able to see the difference on what you're seeing on the TV versus what you're seeing there. The color reproduction, the quality will be slightly different when you are using a different set of monitors. It's a 2 minute hours. And we are not using very high-end microscopes. This is a ReSight viewing system on a Visu 160 old microscope only. These are not like Lumera Eye or something that you are seeing the surgery being done. This is on a Visu 160. See the detailing that you are able to see even when I have cropped the image of this video. It's highly cropped actually. That's it. So then which format to choose? Thanks, Rajesh. Thank you very much. Which format to choose? So you can use compressed format for small size, or you can use an advanced video coding, high definition also can be recorded. And the quality and file size increase. So if it is MP4, it is the smallest. While XAVC HD will have the highest quality, but also the file size will be very big. Now, when you are seeing on this, as I told you, the monitor. So if you are using a 4K shot to show on a HD monitor, actually it will not serve any purpose. So if you have to see this whatever your shot, if you have shot a 4K video, you have to see it on a 4K TV. So if you are not seeing it on 4K TV, you will not be able to appreciate the difference. So you have various options of buying these 4K TVs, and you can or your HD monitor. If you are shooting in HD, use HD monitors. These are cheaper options, or you can see it on TV also. Okay, so all this, whatever we have done now, we have to acknowledge a lot of people who have been through this journey. I would like to acknowledge Dr. Deepak Megur. He was the first to work with the industry and use the Panasonic GH4 for surgical recording for anterior segment. He was the first one to do it, and after that, it was Sumit who demonstrated it for the use of mirrorless cameras, A7S2, for retinal surgeries. And we also validated. So this is how we worked. We compared the indigenous adapter with the Carl Zeiss adapter. Then we used LIA paddles instead of MTF charts to see how they work. And our work has been acknowledged, and we published our work on use and validation of mirrorless cameras in IJO. And we are also happy to announce that our paper was, letter to editor, was accepted in Survey of Ophthalmology with regard to the use of mirrorless cameras. So this is a huge achievement for us. What is important is a penny saved is a penny earned. So we are trying to save as much as possible, and hope it will all benefit all of you. Thank you very much. Next, who's there? Karthik?
Where do you, Raju, how do you, what is the connector you use to transmit it to the LED, and how do you store your data, and where do you store your data?
As far as I'm concerned, I have tried to spend as less as possible. I use internal recording. The camera has got a 64 GB chip, so I record it into the chip only. I am not using any external recorders. And for the external display, you have a micro HDMI to HDMI cable that's available on Amazon. It costs 1,500 rupees for a 10 feet wire. So that I connect it directly to the monitor to view.
And you don't have any kind of recording system?
No, nothing else. I just use camera, and all this have been recorded inside the camera only. Nothing else. I have not used an external recorder. We have an option of external recorder. The limitation of having the Sony camera is that it records for 25 to 28 minutes, and after that you have to restart the button again. So that's the only issue that we have. But otherwise, we don't have that problem. That's why you require an external recorder. Yes, sir.
I have got a Panasonic GH4 mirrorless, and the Sambala guy has given me a beam splitter. He has given me 90-10 splitters, telling that because these are very sensitive cameras. But I think it's not working that much. He also told me that I'll give 80-20. So what is your opinion?
That's what, yeah.
I'm anti-segment surgeon.
For anti-segment, you try juicing up the ISO a little bit. If you can get good quality videos, then you can manage with that. But otherwise, I think you can go for 80-20. That should be sufficient.
And what should be this thing? There is a brightness adjustment also. ISO, you said it can be kept on auto.
Yeah, correct. Auto, there is something called as minimum and maximum. So you increase the maximum thing to slightly higher level.
Correct. And frame rate 25 is sufficient.
Which?
25%.
Do you have any pause system in this camera? Can you pause the movie and then restart?
But only thing, you just press the recording button off and it will stop, and it will restop.
It makes two files, or it will come into the same file?
No, it will be different file.
Two files.
It will be two files. So what we do is, so if you are recording a ERM surgery, so what you do is, just before you are going to peel, just ask your assistant to start so that you don't miss out on those things. See, what we show in, we don't show the whole video in a conference. So the important steps you don't miss out, just ask your assistant to be ready and just start the system if you want an internal recording. If you have an external recording, then there is no limit. It will continue as long as your camera battery works.
Yeah. These cameras have got internal recording.
Yes.
Is there any quality difference between internal recording
and external recording? For external recording, I think Rajesh will cover. It will record in ProRes 422. So that's got better color rendition. But this much, I think, is more than sufficient for all practical purposes. That's what I feel. So I'm this the videos that I showed you, I don't know whether you have to tell me whether these videos were good enough Excellent. To be shown on a conference here. Next we have Dr. Karthik Ameda. He'll be speaking to you regarding use of CCD cameras. Karthik requires no introduction, I guess. Or his father, Dr. M.S. Ravindra, is very famous surgeon, and he will be talking to us regarding how to use this CCTV systems.